Hello, my name is Julianne. This is my Vet 221 dental video. Right now I'm setting up our dental suites, just grabbing everything that we'll need. I have a pack of our probe and scaler and curette right there. I was trying to do this portion by myself, so I apologize for if you miss anything. There's some gauze. Mask, gloves, polish, and we use the UniPro brand, polishing tip, goggles, I'm just going to test the instruments and make sure that they're running and everything's good and that there's water filled. In a minute, I'm just going to speed up the video process, timing-wise, just so you don't have to watch me sit there and clean. That's our ultrasonic scaler. We use the beaver tip. And I have it on 14 power. Don't mind me pulling up my pants. Oh gosh, okay. So that's our ultrasonic scaler. Sorry for all the movement. Swiping down everything, and then I was gonna oil our instruments and put 4 drops of oil in the smaller hole. So for my dental, I'm practicing on my own dog, Lucy. She's a 7-year-old spayed female. She could benefit from a dental as well. She has mild tartar and gingivitis, and she's a grade 2 out of 4 dental. And so now we're just setting up for her IV catheter placement. She's a very good patient to practice on. So I'll be using a 20 gauge catheter in her right cephalic vein. Just grabbing my scrub and flush. And I also have some lidocaine spray to help with the pain. I also sped up the video just to make things go a little faster. Lucy's a very good girl. So I'm using scrub and alcohol. So now I'm flushing her catheter, making sure that it's in the vein, which it was, so huzzah. And now I have my propofol. I have drawn up 13 cc's. She's still awake. She took all 13 of her cc's of propofol, and I just flush. Now it's time to intubate. I'm using a 10 millimeter endotracheal tube and dive that in. And you'll see in a second that I accidentally put it in her esophagus, so I'll have to reintubate her. And I have my assistant mentor double checking me on that, and so I have to pull it back out, yep, and reintubate. I know. That happens sometimes. You just have to make sure you have it in the right place. now I'm attaching her to oxygen using 1 liter per minute and 2% isoflurane. Taking a listen to her, and my assistant's gonna give me some breaths, make sure her tube is in place, listening to both sides of her lungs, and then also listening on the outside of her mouth, making sure I don't hear any whistling or smell any isoflurane. And I have my tech double checking me, making sure everything's in place. I'm attaching her IV fluids, and we have her at the fluid rate of 125 mLs per hour. So I'm starting off examining her teeth, making sure there's no missing teeth. She does have a lot of wear on her canines and incisors. Adjusting lights and attaching my polisher. So I'm starting off probing, just making sure, again, no missing teeth, no pocketing. I'll probe again once I'm done scaling. I don't know if you can tell, but I did notice that Lucy has a growth on her tongue, right cranial aspect of her tongue, and so I just had my doctor check it out. And we did decide to remove it and send it out for biopsy. We're doing a pre-optic just to show our before and after of our pretty teeth. Charting my findings so far. And I wrote down mild gingivitis, mild tartar, and I noted the growth. And she does have some staining on her teeth as well. So now we're doing radiographs. I'm going to start from the back to the front of our teeth. So molars to incisors. And then once we're done polishing, scaling, we'll flip her to our other side and then do the same thing. So right now I have my mentor, Dr. Boyd, double-checking the many radiographs that I took. And then she's also going to probe the teeth and make sure she doesn't find anything of concern. We didn't see anything radiographically that was concerning as well. So that growth was about 2 millimeters. It was just this tiny little tongue growth thing. And we did send it out to Antec to have it biopsied, and it did come back as mesothelial cells, just like an inflammatory response, which is interesting. But she healed quite nicely after this and no issues. So now I'm using my power scaler. We used 14 for power, and we have like medium water setting. And for each tooth, I didn't use it more than 3 seconds, and I just kept moving along her teeth. And made sure I swept along her gingival line and made sure I didn't miss any of the stuff that hides underneath there. Right now I'm using my scaler because I wasn't sure if I found like caries on her tooth. It looked like there's a dark spot on her canine, but it was actually just staining and wear from her, but there was no way to like press on it. There was no indentation, or it wasn't tacky. So I just moved along. After we removed her growth, I was applying pressure with gauze, but it kept bleeding. So I had a tech come help me out, but eventually we cauterize it and make sure it's actually closed and not bleeding all over the place. Poor Lucy. Now I have my polisher and paste. I'm just gonna go ahead and polish this side of her mouth and then we'll flip her. But in a moment, Dr. Boyd will come and cauterize her tongue for me so it can stop bleeding everywhere. It actually wasn't that bad, I'm being dramatic. With my polisher, I tested the polishing piece beforehand, making sure it works. And as I'm going along her teeth, I'm making sure the cup is flared and I'm not spending more than 3 seconds on each tooth as well. And before I apply it to her teeth, I like to scoop up a good amount of paste and spread it around, and then I'll start polishing. So I didn't want to cut in the middle of the procedure, but there is a stopping point right here when Dr. Boyd comes in and cauterizes her tongue, and then it starts up again when we're about to flip Lucy, just because I didn't want to take too much video time of doing another procedure, so I wanted to continue the dental, but she just comes in and quickly cauterizes her tongue, and then we go back to it. I'm also getting my videographer a break. I was using my iPad to record this video. So now that we have her flipped to her other side, we have her hooked up to her EKG leads, just rehooking up everything. I had to continue her fluid rate because it was already an hour. and now we're just going to do radiographs on her left side of her mouth, starting from her molars to her incisors. And I like to do top and then bottom. I didn't see anything radiographically on her left side, nothing of concern. And now I'm just examining the left side of her mouth as well, making sure she's still asleep. And then I'm going to start scaling this side. And again, she didn't have a lot of tartar. It was very mild and mild gingivitis. Nothing too extreme, which is good. No teeth that needed to be extracted. Right now I'm using my curette to pick out that little crevice there on her carnasial, and then I'm going to use my ultrasonic scaler to make sure I can blast whatever that is out of her tooth. Just some tartar, yucky stuff that likes to hide in that crevice. Right now I'm having one of my mentors just double check me, make sure teeth are all nice and clean and scaled. I think she's also just checking for gauze. And then she also wanted to help me make sure that Lucy's teeth are all nice and sparkly and clean. So she wanted to make sure I didn't miss any spots. So now I'm going back in with my ultrasonic scaler and just going back on the teeth that she pointed out that needed a some spots that I didn't see that needed more scaling. Now it's time for rinsing off her polish, and I point in the rostral direction just so you're not spraying at the back of her mouth, and making sure I have all the polish off of her teeth. Dr. Boyd is just coming in, doing her final probing, making sure she's not seeing anything of concern, and then after that I'll use fluoride and spread that around on her teeth for about 30 seconds and then wipe it off with some gauze, and then we'll be finished.